hazards are inherent in launching and launch viewing. By accepting the invitation to view the launch, you do so with the understanding of potential risk. Although NASA applies stringent range safety principles and techniques to protect the general public, workforce, and property for all areas of Wallops Flight Facility and its surrounding areas, during launches, possible hazards could occur, including debris, glass, and toxins. We're all hoping none of that happens. A contingency plan has been developed in preparation for a worst-case launch scenario. In the event that the rocket will need to be destroyed or the rocket fails and detonates near the launch pad, the following emergency procedures will be implemented. During a catastrophic event, a toxic plume containing hydrogen chloride may impact the vicinity. Hydrogen chloride, or HCl, is a strong irritant, primarily affecting the skin, eyes, nose, mouth, throat, and lungs. Exposure effects range from mild irritation to debilitating skin, eyes, or lung damage. The extent and severity of the hazard area will depend on atmospheric conditions and the height of the rocket when the detonation occurs. Prior to launch, modeling of the hazardous plume will be performed to determine possible impact areas. Just as a side note, that was one of the reasons that we were holding on Wednesday, because of the winds and the direction that the winds would have taken the cloud during an early catastrophic event. Although unlikely, should a launch failure occur, you will be directed to leave the mainland immediately. The mainland happens to be where we are going to be, for those of you that aren't familiar with the terminology. Should the launch failure include a possible toxic plume impact upon the mainland, you will need to remain calm but return to your bus as quickly as possible. Make sure that all windows on the bus are closed and remain closed until well out of the danger area. Bus leads will confer with the bus driver to assure all windows are closed and all outside air supplies are shut down. This doesn't really apply for today, but it says you must, for future reference, you should leave on the same bus that you arrive on. Today, obviously, we only have one bus, which makes this much easier. So, in summary, it is imperative that you follow all instructions provided by the NASA personnel. For today, your NASA personnel would be Debbie, myself, my name's David, and Pam, as well as we'll have two folks from Goddard Public Affairs, and you'll see some folks from our Wallops Security Force also. So in the event of a launch failure, do not wait for individual instructions. Begin the return to your bus immediately. It was pointed out on Wednesday, we're not sure what's going to happen today as far as like what kind of loudspeakers or anything like that are available at the media site. But if something happens and we have to corral everybody to get everybody on the bus, we really have no loudspeaker to say, hey, so you should be able to tell if there's a reason that we need to be getting on the bus. Does anybody have a question?
No, but I have some updates.
And Pam right. has some updates for us.
Woo.
Okay, here's the inside scoop. Yeah. Let's see. They're tracking 13 boats right now. All are being cooperative. Orbital has confirmed that they're okay with today's winds. They've been close to the limit most of the day, but the surface winds are trending in the right direction. They've just launched another weather balloon to get wind layer data used to help plan the vehicle trajectory. It also helps them predict the toxic cloud movement, overpressure, and path of falling debris. They've got a helo up now for low-level surveillance, and they've confirmed that the back bay is clear. So safety is confirming that we're green for all planned trajectories.
Roger that.
And I'm going to be getting emails from this saying this is somebody in the range control center. They're going to continue to update me periodically.
Okay.
questions.